Act 3. Here's the one they've all been waiting for in Las Vegas. His original program, Kurt Browning of Caroline, Alberta.
Well, I don't know what it is with Kurt and double axles at the end of his program. Started out so beautifully, the first combination, the triple axle, smooth and so beautifully controlled, very quick step into the double toe, not a problem at all. But then something happened as he continued through this rather dark and mysterious program. The double axle, which is so easy for him, started to tilt. And the left shoulder falling down on the landing, he simply could not hold on.
Well, I don't want to hand him any excuses, but you were talking to his agent, Simon Albert, just yesterday, and he was suggesting that there may be a sore ankle involved in this. And he has been for a while. I don't know that that had anything to do with it, or was it simply a lack of concentration here? First set of marks on a required element for Kurt Browning, reigning world champion.
52354.
Well, he's not suffering too badly in that department. This is his presentation, and he's way up there from 5'7 to 5'9. He was a little bit disappointed that neither Chris Bowman nor Victor Petrenko, two of his toughest challengers, weren't going to be at this competition. He figured that might push him a bit. It may not have been his best, but it's good enough here in Canada for the moment. moment to give Kurt Browning first place.
Well, if anyone's going to... Where he defeated world medalist Christopher Bowman and Viktor Petrenko. Well, those big guns are not here. But Kurt is not resting on his laurels. He has a lot that he still wants to prove. Kurt, you look a lot more relaxed this year than last year. Has there been a big difference?
So far, yeah. Last year, the summer was good, but it seemed to kind of stepped up on me, and I think that my expectations were a little different than everyone else's. And last year just seemed to go by a little too quick, and things happened a little too fast. And to be really honest, when we recouped the whole thing at the end of the season, it didn't seem like that bad of a year. Two bronze medals in my internationals, it would have made me happy any other year, but for some reason it took left a bad taste in my mouth. And you know, this season just seems to be rolling along a lot better, and the priority is on the skating and not where we finish or what people are thinking. And as long as the priority is going to be there, you know, we'll have good results.
Did winning the World Championship for the second time take all the pressure off?
It's had to have helped. I mean, this year, my goal is to just make sure that my skating is my own skating and that I'm really happy with what I'm doing out on the ice. And my expectations for myself are usually pretty high, and if I can satisfy myself, then I should be able to cover a lot of people at the same time. And listen to myself a lot more.
You've been a world champion twice now. What are you going to do this year in order to win again?
This year is a lot of fun because I saved the last year's long program and did it 2 years in a row. And whereas it can be good for saving time and training, after a while it can get a little boring. This year the training is very exciting because a brand new program is both short and long. And the short program especially is a lot of fun to be at home and to do every day. I hope the people like it, but not only is it good for competition, it's fun to train at home.
And you've got some new tricks this year.
And some new toys to throw out in the ice.
Tell us about those.
I'm working this year early in the season to try and find out what new things that I can have for Worlds next year. If there's going to be a third world title, then it's going to need something new. And Skate Canada is a good place to try out some new things. I hope for a good skate because I really want to make these things work to see what the judges respond to and what got the marks and what didn't. So this program is pretty jam-packed. Mm-hmm. And we'll find out what works and what doesn't. And maybe the Skate Canada will help us make decisions for what I'll do in the world.
You to do these new elements? Is it that Kurt Browning wants to try new things just to challenge himself, or do you feel some pressure coming up from behind?
It's kind of a combination of both. You know, there's even today at Skate Canada, there's a skater from France doing triple combinations. And yeah, I've never even met this guy before or even knew his name. And he's doing some really great stuff. I mean, to sit still and be world champion would be to commit suicide out there. So that's not what I want to do. I want to keep going, keep up to everyone else. I mean, it might sound strange to have the world champion say that, but yeah, I just want to keep up to everyone else.
This man, Kurt Browning, two-time defending world champion.
This is a new program for Kurt, to Sons of Italy, choreographed by Brian Power, with some new stuff.
He has one man to beat, his old friend, Grzegorz Felipovsky. Currently in second place, Kurt Browning has to pull it out now.
just
a triple. Sure, throw it on me.
Triple flip, probably, in my opinion, the most difficult triple because of its quick action combined with the triple pull.
There's one very disappointed young Canadian man. Two-time defending world champion, Curt Browning. We'll check his mark in a moment.
Check his performance because it's going to take him at least that long to get off the ice. They're lined up about 10 deep to give him flowers and hugs and kisses and whatnot.
He's so wonderful with the crowd. He always takes time to sign autographs, to talk to people. Wonderful champion. Were not consistent tonight. This was the new combination, the triple sow double loop. He nailed a beautiful one in practice, but it looked like the takeoff of the triple loop did not happen soon enough, and it just got beyond him. Quite a few mistakes. He kept coming back, trying to get the extra jump in out of the triple loop at the end.
Even at that, in part because, Deb, his program is so difficult, he receives excellent marks on technical merit, and these are the highest of the night so far. The lowest from the Canadian judge, surprisingly, a 5-5. That's Sally Rohorick of Canada.
I think she's right. Mark Mitchell's content was much better.
Well, sometimes it helps when you're world champion, doesn't it? Here's artistic impression, and they're high again in the lowest of 5-7, and the highest from the Japanese, 5-9. The Canadian judge again marking the lowest of the bunch at 5-7.
Hi, what's up, girly man?
Tonight was difficult. The only real skater I could watch was Greg, and... You know, both of us seemed to be struggling a little bit. there was parts of the program I'm really proud of, only because it was so difficult. I'll be honest with you, sometimes you step on the ice and those jumps happen so fast and so easy, you almost forget how you did it. Tonight they were hard work, and for example, the second triple axel, just, oh, when I powered that one through, I was so happy. But yeah, something was a little bit out.
What about the quad?
The quad toe, I really felt good going into it. I had the right edge. I was thinking the right thought. It all comes down to doing it at home, and I was putting priority on a short program that would put me up top, and some new combinations. And to tell you the truth, I think it just needs to be done more at home. Every time I step on the ice, I would love to land it, but I know the audience clapped, but I was really disappointed there.
Well, congratulations, Kurt. We're proud of you, with or without the quad.
Yeah, thank you very much.